Hi, welcome to another episode of Try.net. Today we're talking with Maria Naggaga, and we're going to she's going to tell us about a new experience if you want to learn .net.
Yep.
Yeah, tell us. What's new? I hear there's great things.
There are great things. So the cool thing now is that when people are learning how to code, their experiences are starting online. So
Right. Gone
are the days where, you know, you go to a website or you buy a book and then you go and download all the software, or back in the day when they used to have floppies and you had to install everything up.
I think when we first built .NET, you could like go to a special building and get like 7 CDs.
Seriously?
Yeah, I think so.
I haven't even seen a computer with a CD drive in a while.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah. So like the experience, like this was driven from a conversation that I had with Julia, who's our CVP. And I say the way people are learning is different. The online experience is where they want to be. And good documentation, we have to have good documentation, but we also have to have interactive experiences.
Right.
And that is what the birth of try.net.
Right. Yeah. And by online, you really mean a web browser.
Really a web browser, yes.
Yeah.
A web browser, a mobile phone, being able to create an environment where people can learn effortlessly without having to download the tools, making sure they have the right version, making sure that they have the right operating system, the right version of the operating system. Like, how do we remove all those barriers and keep people successful so they actually go and download everything they need
right.
to be successful later?
Yeah, I also heard that there's this other trend,
yeah,
which is not everyone's using a device that looks like that.
Oh, like this?
Like a laptop.
No.
Like some people are, you know, all they have access to is a tablet, and
yep.
some people just phones.
Yeah, most people. So where I'm from, like in Uganda, most people are learning how to code using WhatsApp groups. So I actually mentor a couple of girls back home where I actually answer Q&As in WhatsApp. And they do a lot of their research through those kind of online texting systems and
wow.
stuff like that.
Wow. Yeah. So just so I understand, do you mean WhatsApp?
Yeah.
Okay, pronunciation issue. WhatsApp, yeah.
Yeah, different pronunciations, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. And so are you, so the communication mechanism there is WhatsApp, but
yeah.
are they doing coding in something else?
Yeah, so they'll be coding in something else either at home, like offline, because there isn't like ready access to online over there, to the internet. But also there's an app called MIMO.
Okay.
I don't know if you've heard
no.
of it. So it's one of the number one rated coding apps on the Apple Store.
Really?
So you could actually load it up. There are different challenges, and you can do it on your phone.
Okay, or your iPad.
Or your iPad.
Yeah.
But most of them, it's their phone, and it's also on Android, which is the most popular device in pretty much most of Africa, yeah.
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 I think it's actually the most popular device in the world.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, so not just Africa.
Yeah.
Okay, how about you show us what you've got?
Okay, so this is docs.microsoft.com. And back in the day, what you would have is you would have all this text right here in the middle. So just here. And you'd have to read through it and say, okay, this is console.writeLine. They're showing me one line of code. Okay, I have to install something. Let's say I have to install Visual Studio.
Mm.
Come back tomorrow and let's get up and running.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of drop-off where people actually weren't using this on a regular basis, especially new developers. So imagine if I could read these instructions and then I'm like, okay, let me see what it does. And I could copy it over here and paste it and run it in the editor. And you have your Hello World
yep.
experience.
And it showed up.
It showed up. So you didn't have to install anything. You could actually go through the whole process. So you can actually go over to the next challenge. And as you can see, I've done this a number of times, so I've cheated.
Oh, no.
I cheated several times.
I have faith in you.
But you could actually go in and declare variables, and there are a whole bunch of different other quick start tutorials that the docs team is doing a brilliant job in creating these interactive experiences.
Nice.
They'll also be in the reference docs as well. So even for
Which
developers.
Is a perfect place for
yeah,
them.
Yeah, we did an experiment just before I went on vacation last year, and we got more retweets with the reference docs than we did with the quick start. People were blowing, like they're crazy.
I completely believe that.
Yeah.
I mean, when I'm doing development, I'll totally start in the reference docs,
yep.
and then I move over to the other docs when I need to learn a bigger concept.
Yep.
One thing that just came to mind that I had never thought about with this experience before is, the one is this kind of, you know, you don't have to install a bunch of stuff in your machine. We kind of got that covered.
Yep.
The other one is, for some people, you know, there's these English docs, you know, reading kind of a wall of text is a bit of a challenge. But I can imagine for some people that are not really, I hesitate to use the word competent, you know, just aren't super familiar with English, that having this kind of model might actually be easier for them, because you don't actually have to learn English quite to the same degree, because as soon as you know what the console type is, then you can kind of like work your way through it.
Oh yeah, and that only doesn't work with people who have English as a second language, but like, for example, I'm dyslexic, so when I see huge amount of text, I'm just like, oh, I cannot deal with this. So having those blocks in between where you have like 1 to 3 lines and I'm able to just run the code and see how it works without getting overwhelmed, it gives you that level of confidence, even as a professional developer. So I absolutely love this.
Makes sense.
I've actually demoed this. So this is try.net in its raw form. So
okay, what did you just do? Slow that down a little bit.
So this is what it can look like if people go and embed the experience and they're able to customize it as they would like.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. So that's it in its nice, production, lovely, like,
I see.
Usable form.
Okay, so you just switch tabs.
So I switch tabs.
And kind of because you know the right people, you know what you knew which other URL to go to.
Yeah, since I own try.net, so it's actually try.net, which is a horrible URL, and we know, and we're working on that. But this is your playground. You can run a console application here.
So this is anyone can go to this URL.
Anyone can go to this URL and start playing around with it. And if you go try.net/docs, and I am working, and I'm going to be deploying this very soon. I'm working on a better documentation page. But this actually shows you all the different things that you can do currently with our API. So you're able to set the source code to whatever you like. You can run the code, and we actually have a message log at the bottom, which we found that a lot of professional developers that we work with absolutely love this because it shows them what is running in the back end.
Totally.
Which they love, but we need to make it a little bit more user-friendly for the everyday person who is not a C# or JavaScript developer out there. And you can also, we introduced customizing of themes, so you can actually customize this to any theme that you like.
Right. Yeah. Now, you just said there's kind of like the nicely embedded form and the raw form. Is this experience hosted anywhere else other than docs? And is that something we're trying to make happen?
So this experience, currently we're just running an experiment with Canvas. So I don't know if you know Canvas.
Yeah, I think you've told me about
Canvas,
it.
Canvas, which, like, if anyone's using Moodle out there, it's very similar. So online learning experience management systems. And it was a very positive response. It was a very small sample space of 15 students, but it's going to scale to a bigger group of students over the next year. We're also in conversation with other third-party documentation providers of very popular APIs, so they start embedding this experience as well.
So it sounds like we're pretty open to that.
We're very open, and like this is the best time to start reaching out to me and say, I want this. I've had Twilio reach out to me on Twitter, and we're running experiments with them, and a couple of other third-party documentation providers
as
well.
So we've probably all done a bit of JavaScript.
Yep.
There's a site that we've probably all used, like I think it's JS Fiddle.
Yep.
Should I think of this similarly to JS Fiddle? Is that the frame, or is it different?
You should think of this as JS Fiddle. I also think of it in terms of like a JS Fiddle with a little bit of a code pen. Coming together in this, I love CodePen in this very .NET experience. So
Now the one thing I liked about JS Fiddle that I actually don't see here, at least so far, you can kind of create your own like JS Fiddle files.
Yeah.
And send out kind of like a Bitly styled link.
That it's I actually left my engineering team working on that right now.
Okay.
So that is coming.
Okay.
Yeah, that is coming. But we're also working on multiple file support, so you can actually build a Razor page application right here.
Oh my gosh.
We're working on things like being able to take your solution and open it up right in Visual Studio Code and run it. So giving you that confidence of like, oh, you finished this tutorial, you have some sort of working app, go and do whatever you want with it. So giving you that skeleton that you can work with.
Right, so what I hear you saying is, if you started here with the try.net site, you don't then have to like recreate all your steps somewhere else.
No.
You can just basically transfer it and
open it up in an editor of your choice, which we would prefer is Visual Studio.
makes sense. Okay, that sounds awesome.
So
have you guys ever considered Gist? GitHub Gist integration? Has people talked about that?
Yes, we have talked about all that.
Okay,
so
awesome.
Like, you're building out our roadmap.
Yeah, you can see I'm starting to get excited about this.
Yeah.
I know on my team, like, we use Gists to handle stuff back, like, all the time.
So, like imagine being able to share your code on Twitter or with a friend or a colleague. Like, I think that's another thing that we want to start doing as well, is being able to easily share your code easily across the different places. Not collaboration, but just being able to share it.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah.
Right. We're not yet talking about co-writing thing, like Office 365.
No, we're not there. We're not there yet, no.
Okay. A few more sprints.
Yeah.
Awesome. So it sounds like if I want to learn C#, probably if people who are watching the show mostly already know it, but if I know people who want to learn the language, or I know like coding schools that are trying to teach C# and .NET, then this link.
This is where they can go.
Now, but if I already know .NET and I just want to learn more about some new API or some concept, then the docs now have this experience built in, and my experience of learning .NET is now going to be tremendously better.
Yes. And this is just the beginning. It's just the beginning, yeah.
Anything else you want to share? I take it it works in all the browsers that I would care about.
It works in all the browsers. We've had some issues with Safari.
Okay.
But all the other browsers, it's great.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I assume we're working on that in some
way. We're working on Safari. Like, there's an open issue. So if you go to our GitHub page, which is, which I don't know offhand, but yeah. I will grab it. But it's github.com/.net/try/issues.
Yep.
We do have a couple of issues up there. And one of the ones which are still open is about Safari.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, because I heard that there are some mobile phones in the world that run that browser.
Yeah, there are a few out there. Yeah, there are a few.
Awesome. Well, maybe you guys in 6 months or something will have something more to show. It looks like you're moving super fast.
We are. Like, it's just like I blink my eyes and then there's a whole new feature.
Yeah,
so I'm really happy.
I happen to know the engineering team that you're working with.
And they're great.
They're awesome.
They are great. Love working with them.
Okay, thanks for showing this to us today. I think everyone's going to love it.
Yeah, and please tweet me if you have any questions or any feedback. I'm looking forward to it.
Okay,
thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks for watching another show on try.net, and I hope you check out, or sorry, on .NET, and I hope you try out the try.net web experience.
Yes.
Yeah, thank
you. All right, thank you.